We want to evaluate the given log expression if natural log x equals 2, natural log y equals 3, and natural log z equals 5. So we want to expand this expression as much as possible using the properties of logarithms given here, and then evaluate using the given information. One thing we have to be careful about here, though, is taking a look at this second logarithm. Notice now we have natural log x divided by y to the negative 1 raised to the second power. So while it might be tempting to try to apply the power property of logarithms given here, where if we have log x to the n, this is equal to n times log x. But this is only true when the exponent n is attached to x, or the number part of the logarithm. This property does not apply if the entire logarithm is being raised to an exponent, which is what we have. So we'll have to expand the logarithm inside and then end up squaring the result. But looking at the first natural log, we can apply the power property of logarithms because we have z raised to the power of negative 1. So we can rewrite this first logarithm as negative 1 times natural log z. So we have negative 1 natural log z. And now for the second set of parentheses, which is still going to be squared, we want to expand natural log x divided by y raised to the power of negative 1. Now if we wanted to, we could rewrite this fraction using positive exponents, meaning if we have x divided by y to the negative 1, if we were to move y to the negative 1 up to the numerator, it would change the sign of the exponent, so this is just equal to x times y. So we could write this as natural log xy and then expand it, but let's go ahead and leave it like it is and expand it using the quotient property of logarithms, where if we have the log of a quotient, it's equal to log x minus log y. So in this case, we'd have natural log x minus natural log y to the power of negative 1. And now for the last step, we can apply the power property of logarithms here, where we can move the exponent of negative 1 to the front. Notice how if we did that, we'd have minus negative 1 natural log y, but subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So let's go ahead and write this as negative natural log z, and then we have natural log x, again, plus natural log y, and all this is still squared. And now in this form, we'll perform substitution for natural log x, natural log y, and natural log z. So we would have negative natural log z. Natural log z is 5, this is negative 5. And then here we have natural log x, which is 2, plus natural log y, which is 3, but this is squared. So we have negative 5 times, this would be 5 squared, which is just negative 5 times 25. So our expression is equal to negative 125. I hope you found this helpful.